Today I'm going to give lecture on directive resonator antenna. So all of us have seen our various antennas made up of metals, but here I'm going to discuss with you next generation antenna, that is DRA. Directive DRA is a low loss antenna for wireless applications because of the following reason. As the lower microwave band is very much crowded, it is required to shift to higher microwave and millimeter wave frequency operation. Also, to support high data rate applications and to accommodate increasing number of users, wideband antenna systems need to be designed. We already have studied the microstrip antenna in our syllabus, which has many advantages and is widely used at microwave bands, but when it is used for higher microwave and millimeter wave band, its performance is degraded due to increased conductor losses. So here we are studying the topic, which is not in our syllabus, but which is very useful in higher microwave and millimeter wave application. So availability of low loss temperature stable microwave directive materials draw the attention of researchers to investigate DRA, that is dielectric resonator antenna, for microwave and millimeter wave band. So introduction of dielectric resonator. In 1939, R.D. Richmeyer showed that the non-metallic objects also resonate for narrow range of frequencies, which he called dielectric resonators. A dielectric resonator is an electronic component that exhibits resonance for a narrow range of frequencies, generally in the microwave and millimeter wave band. Dielectric resonators generally consist of a puck of ceramic that has a low dissipation factor. Dielectric resonator applications. Dielectric resonators have been widely used in shielded microwave circuits such as cavity resonators, filters, and oscillators. Dielectric resonator, when kept inside the metal cavity, offers high quality factor and it acts as a dielectric resonator filter. Dielectric resonator, when used at input or output stage of the tuned circuit inside the metallic cavity, work as dielectric resonator oscillator, that is DRO. DRO offers high FM noise performance and frequency stability over conventional resonators and used for the higher frequency generation. In recent years, dielectric resonators are also used as an antenna in microwave and millimeter wave band. Dielectric resonator filter is shown in figure 2A and dielectric resonator oscillator is shown in figure 2B. Now, what is dielectric resonator antenna? Dielectric resonator, when kept in an open environment with proper excitation, act as an antenna, and hence it is named as dielectric resonator antenna. Dielectric resonator antennas are fabricated from low loss temperature stable microwave dielectric materials. Resonant frequency of dielectric resonator antenna is a function of size, shape, and dielectric constant of dielectric resonator. A dielectric resonator antenna is shown in figure 3, where a cylindrical disc type dielectric resonator is placed in a ground plane which is fitted with a microstrip line. Now, dielectric resonator antenna works in the principle of radio waves. So, radio waves are introduced inside the dielectric resonator material from the transmitter circuit and bounce back and forth between the resonator walls, forming standing waves. The walls of the resonator are partially transparent to radio waves. Allows the radio power to radiate into space. Dielectric resonator antenna has various advantages over microstrip antenna. Dielectric resonator antenna can be easily integrated with MMIC circuit, that is microwave and millimeter wave integrated circuits, due to its small size and low volume. DRA is made up of low loss microwave dielectric materials and has very low dielectric loss. DRA has no conductor and surface wave losses. It also does not have frequency drift with temperature variation, as made up of temperature stable microwave dielectric materials. It is easily excited with existing feed methods such as probe feed, microstrip feed, etc. DRA is a volumetric source and has larger effective aperture, thus it also offers good radiation power factor and high radiation efficiency. So these are the advantages of DRA over microstrip antenna, and because of this, this is preferred antenna to be used in microwave, high microwave and millimeter wave. Design aspects of DRA are shape of the DRA, dimensional parameter of the DRA, permittivity and dielectric constant of DR material and substrate, matching and coupling method. So we can say that the performance of the dielectric resonator antenna depends on shape, dimensional parameters, permittivity, excitation or the coupling method. So we can see that we have the more controlling parameter in DRA in comparison to microstrip antenna. Various possible shapes of dielectric resonator antennas are rectangular DRA, which has high flexibility in designing and offers low cross polarization. Another popular shape of dielectric resonator antenna is cylindrical DRA, which offers circular polarization, but it has degenerate modes. Ring DRA is another shape of DRA which is widely used nowadays, in which a small cylindrical portion has been cut from the cylindrical DRA to avoid the problem of degenerate modes. So it offers advantage over cylindrical DRA. This is a field distribution inside the rectangular DRA. It follows the dielectric waveguide model. So consider the DRA placed on infinite ground plane, which is shown in figure 13. And ground plane can be replaced by isolated DRA using image theory. So if we have selected the antenna of size H, with the help of image theory, ground plane can be replaced by replaced, and the height of the antenna can be 2H. Now we apply the dielectric waveguide model, assuming permanent electric conductor at Z equal to 0 and permanent magnetic conductor at Z equal to H and X equal to 1 by 2. And field continuity is present at Y equal to W by 2 planes for TE11D mode. And in this way, the resonant frequency can be analyzed. We can see the field variation inside the rectangular DRA along the L, X and Z direction, X, Y and Z direction. Resonant frequency can be calculated by FR equal to C by 2 pi under root of epsilon R KX plus KX square plus KY square plus KZ square. So if we have to calculate the resonant frequency, first resonant frequency for TE11 mode, we can use FR1 formula, and if we want to calculate the resonant frequency of FR2, we need to take the another formula. KY equal to under root of K square minus K X square minus KZ square. K naught square into epsilon R equal to KX square plus KY square plus KZ square. KX equal to pi by L. KZ equal to pi upon 2H. and kz equal to 3 pi by kz1 equal to 2 pi by 2h. If we have the t two modes, then kz2 will be calculated and equal to 3 pi by 2h. So for the dual band designing, the frequency selection criteria for TE11M and TE11N mode, where N should be greater than M, is F2 upon F1 should be less than under root of N square plus 1. K1 and K2 are wave numbers in dielectric, and K0 is the free space wave number, which is equal to 2 pi F0 upon C. F0 is a frequency in free space. K equal to 2 pi under root of epsilon R F upon C. So Kx, Ky, and Kz are the wave numbers in X, Y, and Z directions respectively, which can be determined from the boundary conditions, and epsilon R is a dielectric constant of dr. The difference between FR1 and FR2 mainly depends on KZ1, KZ2, or height of dr. So here FR1 is the resonant frequency for TE11M mode, and FR2 is the resonant frequency for TE11N mode. So when we are, these are the formula which are used for dual band designing. Dielectric waveguide model only considered the image and isolated DRA. So dimensions of DRA may be adjusted accordingly when we are applying the coupling to the dielectric resonator antenna. Now these are the general design formula which is used during the coupling of the dielectric resonator antenna. So first of all, we will see the stub length, which is equal to lambda g by 4, where lambda g is a guide wavelength. And guide wavelength can be calculated as lambda g equal to lambda naught upon under root of ER effective, where lambda naught is a frequency, is a wavelength of signal, and ER effective is a epsilon R effective is a effective dielectric constant of the material. WS is a slot width equal to 0.2 LS, and LS is a slot length which is equal to 0.4 lambda naught upon epsilon R effective. Effective dielectric constant equal to HT upon HDRA upon epsilon DRA plus HS upon epsilon S, where HT is a total height of DRA, HDRA is the height of the DRA, epsilon DRA is the dielectric constant of the DRA, S is a height of the substrate, epsilon S is a dielectric constant of substrate. Yeah, permittivity of the substrate. Effective dielectric constant so ER effective is taken as effective dielectric constant of an entire structure of the DR. Feed line dimension should have the ratio of LF upon WF approximately equal to 3.96 to get the better performance in antenna. LF is the length of the feed line and WF is the width of the feed line. Resonant frequency. It is a frequency for which DRA offers resonance, that is the maximum output. In the return loss plot, frequency with minimum return loss is referred to as a resonant frequency. Return loss. Return loss is a measure of reflected power and signifies the antenna matching. It is defined as the ratio of reflected power to the incident power. Bandwidth. Antenna bandwidth is a bit of frequency over which the antenna maintains required characteristics. Bandwidth can also be calculated from return loss plot and referred to as a return loss bandwidth, from which DRA maintains the return loss below 10 dB, minus 10 dB. Percentage bandwidth is equal to FH minus FL upon FC into 100%. FH is a higher frequency in the band, FL is a lower frequency in the band, FC is a central frequency. Central frequency can be further calculated as FH plus FL upon 2. Bandwidth can also be calculated in terms of SN quality factor. SWRN quality factor. So bandwidth equal to S minus 1 upon Q radiation minus of under root of S, where Q radiation is a radiation quality factor, S is a SWR ratio. Q factor is also related to the dielectric losses in the dielectric material. Higher the Q factor, the better the material. So Q is equal to 2 pi total energy stored by antenna upon energy dissipated or radiated per cycle. Q radiation means the radiation quality factor is equal to 2 omega naught WE upon P radiation. And Q dissipation quality factor is equal to omega naught W upon PD, which is equal to 1 by 10 delta. So 10 delta here is a loss tangent of dielectric material, which can also be calculated as sigma upon omega epsilon naught epsilon r, where sigma is the conductivity, epsilon naught is the free space permittivity, and R is the relative permittivity. These are some of the microwave dielectric materials which are offered by various manufacturers with its specific dielectric constant. So we can see that Al2O3 has a dielectric constant in between 11 to 12. And TiO2 is having a dielectric constant of 50. These materials can be provided by various manufacturers which are listed in the table, and these materials can be used for manufacturing the dielectric resonator antenna to offer the different performances. Thank you so much.